The city of Fitchburg has a number of schools that are already outfitted with solar arrays. Right here at Fitchburg High School, we're in the process of building large solar canopies, and we're really excited about what this is going to bring to the school.
Currently at Fitchburg High, we're covering solar canopies for two parking lots, and once the system is turned on, we'll be actively feeding into the electrical infrastructure of the school and offsetting some of the energy that it typically consumes. The designs on the solar canopy were all designed by my team.
My name is Bobby Bowman. I'm a senior project manager. I work with Deep in the electrical engineering team. We build a lot of projects with schools, and schools, like many other commercial buildings, use a lot of energy. So our goal is to make sure that those projects maintain their full capacity throughout their lifetime.
The basic components are solar panels that go up on the roof of this solar canopy. Then they feed into an inverter, which is a device that converts the DC that's coming out of the solar panels into AC, the electricity that we get all in our houses and schools. So what we're looking at here at the base of the canopy, there's a rebar cage that goes into the ground, and there's concrete that's poured around it. There's a ground wire that basically grounds for any lightning strikes. If you touch the canopy itself, you're never gonna be electrocuted. There are 10 screws, all get bolted on, and then you got steel purlins on which the modules are mounted. This is a standard Y frame. It's 2 to 5 degree tilt on the canopy that helps with the water management and also tilts the canopies towards the south, where the most optimal exposure to the sun is. Projects like this involve a lot of disciplines working together. There's this constant back and forth between the design team and the construction team where we're learning from each other.
There's a whole team of design engineers. There's geotechnical, structural, there's electrical, there's trenching, excavation for foundations, steel workers, landscapers. There's the service technicians that help make sure it operates properly. It really does take a team.
Since I got out of the military, I started here. They took a chance on me and they're like, hey man, we want you to help build solar projects. So here we are making stiffeners. Their job is to keep the purlings as straight as possible. You're adding them in certain spots. Overall, it reinforces the entire structure for panels to be laid on.
The biggest challenge with this project was, okay, we have two parking lots and they all need to come together as one system.
Typically, we need to do a long trench, which can be not very cost effective.
The longer you run on electrical cables, you're not gonna get the full voltage.
In this case, our engineers came up with a good plan to route up and over the building. Not only is that shorter trench route more cost effective, it also limits our voltage drop.
I think it shows progress in the school and how we're moving towards a clean energy future. It's a great example for other places in our community and how they can add more green energy.
It's better for the cars if it is sunny, there is shade, and I feel like it will allow us to put money into better things.
We expect to generate 40 to 50% of electrical output at Fitchburg High with these canopies. That equates to about $20,000 to $25,000 a year savings for the city of Fitchburg.
When the project is complete, we'll have a full suite of monitoring with an online dashboard where anyone can see exactly how much energy is being produced. They can measure that against what the school is expecting to produce, and they can really see how much energy is being offset.
Massachusetts, in my opinion, is one of the most progressive states in terms of renewable energy adoption, and that's what I chose to get my master's. At UMass Lowell, came across the MassCEC internship program and immediately got access to Select Energy. Everything that I know today wouldn't have been possible without the MassCEC internship program.
If students come forward with, hey, we want to see more green energy initiatives, my recommendation is go to your administration at your school, outline what you would like to see done and how you're going to be a part of that. When school building administration gets information and kids are excited about something, they usually go out of their way to try to help make that happen.
Limiting our reliance on fossil fuels is one of the key challenges we're facing right now. The goals that Massachusetts has to provide renewable energy means that there's going to be jobs in this area for many years to come.